They're fine with adding another $500 million to the deficit, you know, but then they go after food aid for poor people. I mean, it's like, what the hell is going on here? You know, where are their priorities?
McGovern from Massachusetts is talking about a bill that is to loosen pistol braces, which are for guns, and it's introduced by Andrew Clyde, and we'll get to that. But the measure, as it is introduced by Representative Andrew Clyde, would put a halt to a Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms and Explosives rule announced in January that places further regulations on stabilizing braces for pistols. These arm braces are mounted to the rear of a pistol to make it easier to shoot with one hand. Continuing, the ATF rule categorizes pistols with braces as short-barreled rifles, which require a federal license to own. The White House has argued this reclassification is necessary because the gun industry uses braces to work around regulations on short-barreled rifles, which shoot more accurately. Let's talk about Andrew Clyde for a second. You may know him because he is famous for having said that the January 6th crowd were tourists walking through the Capitol. That's the guy. He is a former gun shop. He's a gun shop owner. He actually still owns a gun store in Georgia. All his campaign paraphernalia was emblazoned with semi-automatic and automatic rifles. He wears a lapel pin and gives them out to other members of the Republican caucus that has an AR-15. This is a gun guy. The Biden administration has already said they will veto the bill, noting the device has been used in mass shootings in Dayton, Ohio, and Boulder, Colorado. And here is Jim McGovern again talking about this, talking about what Clyde is trying to put through.
I get it. The bill's author owns a gun shop and makes millions from selling guns and gun accessories, including stabilizing braces. Sure, sounds like a conflict of interest to me, but we are considering it because Speaker McCarthy is trying to put down a far right rebellion. So we will vote on a bill to make it easier to kill people. He has given away everything to a small group of radical Republicans who will continue to demand more and more from him, apparently now including letting them dictate exactly what bills come to the floor.
Max, I'm putting a lot on you with this question. Talk a little bit about the quid pro quo that McGovern's talking about, this small group of radical Republicans that have Speaker McCarthy by the, you know, neck, let's say.
Yeah, all this Trump talk really does distract from the fact that there's a whole government Republicans are failing to run. And Speaker McCarthy's a prime example of that. He wasn't even able to do business at all last week because the Freedom Caucus, this band of far right MAGA Republicans, effectively stopped him from opening business in the House for several days. So he just gave up and said, we'll come back next week and maybe the government will work then. And it seems now in return for being allowed to actually do his job, Kevin McCarthy has just agreed to let the Freedom Caucus decide what goes to the floor, what doesn't, what gets a vote. And it's clear now that Kevin may be the speaker, but it is the Freedom Caucus's voice we're hearing loud and clear here.
And they're saying, Max, that they were the ones that gave him the speakership, so they're entitled to this, right? I mean, that's the quid pro quo here, right? That we didn't want to support your speakership. We wanted to actually have someone else put in there, and we wanted to make it you squirm all night, which we did do. And now you went ahead with this debt ceiling increase, so we're going to get back at you. Is that what's going on here too?
Exactly. I mean, the debt ceiling was the red line. Freedom Caucus Republicans said, you know, we supported you for speaker on the explicit agreement you wouldn't negotiate with Democrats on things like this. And in return, don't expect anything else you want to happen for the rest of your term. Whatever's going to go up is going to be what the Freedom Caucus wants. And so we're seeing this parade of extremist legislation, and this gun braces is just the start.
And so, Waz, you know, Max talked about being distracted by Trump, and what's going on in Washington is obviously terribly important in real time. But, you know, these are still the people that are fighting for these braces and the Andrew Clydes and the Freedom Caucus. These are Trump's people, right? So are they appealing to Trump as well at the same time and saying, we're still here for you and we're fighting the battles you want us to fight on the Hill against McCarthy?
I think when you mentioned that the Freedom Caucus and the sort of rightward fringe of the party had McCarthy by the short hairs, you had it exactly right. Once they made him grovel to get the speakership that he so desperately wanted, that he was able, that he was willing to debase himself both publicly and privately to achieve that end. This was always going to be the outcome of his speakership. They were gonna bully him and dictate terms to him at every single turn because he initially negotiated with these people. And I guess they demonstrated that they were willing to sort of blow up the government and blow up his bid for speakership and never even have a speaker if this guy did not deal with them. And now he's sort of reaping the benefits of that negotiation. And this is just what it's gonna be. And so far as these people are Trump people, I don't know that they're Trump people more so than they are just what the fringe of the right has been for 30 years. Only back in the days, the GOP used to only play footsie with these folks, right? And they could sort of, you know, pat them on the head and said, yeah, we'll play lip service to your crazy, cranky ideas. And then we're gonna, you know, nominate our George Bushes and Mitt Romneys and John McCains and so on and so forth. However, as time has passed on, they've legitimized many of those ideas. And those people who we called part of the lunatic fringe, they amassed power and even got themselves elected. And now they're actually have their hands on the wheels of power, and we're seeing the consequences of that. This is what the Republicans have sort of reaped, guys.
Yeah, and McCarthy could be the last line of defense to a lot of this, and he's tried to be in pushing them back as much as they can. But their power and the fact that just one person can basically have a vote on whether or not he should remain, can call a vote on whether or not is called a motion to vacate, whether or not he can even be speaker, they have a lot more power disproportionate to what they should have, and that any sort of faction of Congress has ever had, certainly in recent times. Max, is there anything, does McCarthy have anywhere to go? I mean, you see him fumbling on Donald Trump. You see him unable to open Congress, as you reminded us. As Waz just said, he is the most self-debasing person that we've seen in Congress and it's a sufficient role in Congress. What are his options?
Yeah, I mean, things are dwindling for Kevin McCarthy. He has no real base within his party anymore. The problem is even people who maybe don't dislike Kevin McCarthy also acknowledge that he is a terrible political strategist, that he has guided the Republican Party from one avoidable defeat to the other, including this debt ceiling bill, which essentially split the GOP in two just in time for primaries. So even if they like him, they're not willing to stake their political reputation on Kevin McCarthy's ability to do his job. And after this last 2 weeks, I mean, that's a pretty safe bet.
We know like a year and a half's a lifetime in politics. So we don't have an election until November of 2024. I mean, it's such a long time away, even though it seems like it's tomorrow. It's not. And a lot can happen, a lot will happen. The Republicans seem like they are in total disarray, both the way they're governing, the way they have a presidential candidate getting indicted on 37 counts. But we all know that you can blink and forget that pretty quickly in the way the world works today. Is there a picture in which they recover from this, Waz?
It's hard to see a way out in the immediate future. I think in order to see some progress, they'd have to burn this whole thing down as it existed and be willing to lose a few election cycles in a row, meaning they'd have
they'll never be willing to lose
election. That's what I'm saying. They would have to be willing to relinquish power in the short term to sort of regather steam and get these people out of the paint, so to speak. But no, the power is too enticing and quite frankly, it's too lucrative. These people, a lot of these people, frankly, before they even get elected, they're already millionaires. And the way the, you know, the sort of revolving door of government and private enterprise interact with each other these days. They know the kind of payouts. Like when McCarthy gets ousted, the day he no longer wants to be part of the Republican Party, he will have a multi-million dollar job on some nonsense board waiting for him. And they know that. And they know that they can only achieve those riches by staying in power. So it's hard for me to see them breaking this wheel.
They'll still have to go home to Bakersfield, though. So there's that. Max, very quickly, because we got to get out of here. There's more TYT coming your way, but I want to give you a shot at that. Is there a way out for this guy?
The only way out is through the door. But you know, the sad thing is, as Wass said, you don't have to be good to make a lot of money in politics. You just need to cling to power long enough. And really, that seems to be all Kevin's looking for at this point.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.